So good morning students. Today we are going to start unit number 4. Unit number 4 is having two parts. Part A which deals with polyphase AC circuits and part B deals with single phase AC transformer. So in this class we are going to see the polyphase AC circuits. Poly means more than one or many. So the AC circuit which is having more than one phases, it is called as a polyphase AC circuit. In unit number 3, we have seen single phase AC circuit. So, single phase AC circuit means what? The AC circuit which deals with single phase. So, in those particular circuits, we have dealt with the supply voltage which is having only two terminals. One terminal is phase and another terminal is neutral. So, in those circuits, we have seen only phase terminal was only one. So, that's why that particular supply is called as a single phase AC supply. And in this unit number 4, we are going to deal with the AC circuits which is having more than one phases. As it is having more than one phases, the circuit is called as a polyphase AC circuit. In polyphase AC circuit, let's see the example which we are using daily in our life. Okay. Now the image which is in front of you is having four terminals called R, Y, B and N. The R terminal is given for red line, Y terminal is given for yellow line, B terminal is given for blue line and N terminal is given for black line. Now what this line indicates and what this color indicates? This line indicates these are the phases, phase wires. Okay. So in our home, when we are inserting 2-pin plug, okay, in that 2-pin plug, the one terminal is acting as a phase and another terminal is acting as a neutral. Okay, and if you have seen the color coding for your wiring, the black color wire is always there and the red color wire is always there. Okay, so black color is always reserved for neutral and any other color, maybe red or yellow or green or blue, it's for phase. So in our home appliances, these three colors, red, yellow and blue, these are reserved for three-phase AC supply. Three-phase AC supply is having three phases. So, first phase is having color code red. Second phase is having color code white, yellow. And third phase is having color code B, blue. So, always the sequence of the phase is red, yellow, blue. So, the three-phase AC supply, when I want to call their name of the phases, I'll call the name in a standard sequence that RYB. My three-phase AC supply is having the sequence of phases in standard manner is RYB, red, yellow, blue. So red color, yellow color and blue color, these are the color codes reserved for three phases of three-phase AC supply. So these are the three lines showing that these are the three live wires of the three-phase supply are there, or these are the three phases of three phase AC supplies are there. And N color is having black, that is N is a neutral, that neutral wire is having black in color. Now there are four different equipments connected to this three phase AC supply. The first equipment is three phase motor, which is used in industry for high power application. As it is a three phase motor, it requires three phase AC supply. So this three phase AC supply is given by red color, that is first phase red, then yellow color, that is second phase yellow phase, and the third phase, that is the blue phase. So this red color wire, yellow color wire and blue color wire is connecting from three live phases on three phase AC supply, that is red, yellow and blue, and the motor has energized to give the certain output or the specified output for that industrial application. Now the second equipment is the power socket that we are using in our home. So the power socket is having now three terminals, that is called three pin socket. So to have this three pin socket, I can even insert 2-pin plug. Okay, so to energize this power socket, which we are seeing in our home also, okay, which is used in home or say offices. So for energizing this power socket, we are going to give single phase AC supply. And to give single phase AC supply to this power socket, we are giving one phase and one neutral. Now we are connecting one phase, so out of this RYB, we have given red phase to this power socket. So red phase anti-neutral is going to complete its circuit, and as it is having red phase, that is one phase and one neutral, it is called as a single phase AC supply. Now the third equipment is the CFL lamp. CFL lamp also we are using in our home. Okay, so CFL lamp is also working on single phase AC supply. Now to energize the CFL lamp, we have connected yellow phase and neutral, that is black in wire. Okay, so it is having two wires, yellow color and black color wire. So yellow color is giving one phase and black color wire is giving neutral. So it is also having single phase AC supply, which consists of one phase wire and one neutral wire. So CFL lamp is energized by yellow phase, power socket is energized by R phase, and the last equipment which is having fan. Okay, this fan is having single phase AC motor. So this single phase motor is going to have single phase AC supply. So this fan is connected to blue phase and neutral. So blue wire and black wire is going to connect to the fan, which is also having single phase AC supply in terms of blue phase and the neutral. So here in this particular figure, the first equipment requires three phase AC supply, and second, third and fourth equipment which we are using in our home, we are using in offices, okay, in commercial way. So these equipments require single phase AC supply, and to give them single phase AC supply, we have given different phases. So to power socket we have given R phase, to CFL we have given yellow phase, and to fan we have given blue phase. So this way even do with the residential complex also. See, suppose if the building is of 10 floor, okay, then we can say including ground floor, okay, ground floor, first floor, second floor, third floor, these floors will work on R phase and neutral. Then the remaining three floors, 4, 5, 6, will work on yellow phase and neutral, okay, and then again remaining floors will work on blue phase and neutral. So if any supply problem is there, okay, and if suppose any single phase is not working, suppose R phase is not working, then instead of having complete building shutdown or complete building will have isolation from the supply or will have power cut down issue, what will happen, only four floors which were having R phase supply, okay, will not have any input power or will not have energy, okay, they'll have power cut down issue, but remaining floors, okay, like 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, these floors will have the power because they have yellow phase and blue phase. So to distribute the power in the optimized way, the three phase AC supply is distributed in such a way that the one phase is going to certain part, the second phase is going to certain part, and third phase is going to certain part, even in industry, so that whenever we have the power issue, only certain part will have isolated, okay, the other part will be healthy. So in this figure, what we studied that we have single phase equipments, we have three phase equipments. Three phase equipments require three phase AC supply. Single phase equipments require single phase AC supply. Single phase AC supply requires any one phase and neutral. And three phase AC supply requires all three phases. Okay. Now, the next is, when I have three phase supply, okay, then I have to draw its waveform by using three different sinusoidal waveforms. Now the first waveform is the A, okay, that name actually it is RYB, okay, but in industry the name of red color phase is given by A, the yellow color phase is given by B, and the blue color phase is given by C. So ABC waveforms are for red color R, yellow color Y, and C color blue. Okay, so ABC waveforms are the three phase sinusoidal waveform which is showing you three phase AC supply. Now in this particular case, the red color phase, okay, which is having red color sinusoidal waveform, is going to start its positive half cycle at omega t equal to 0 degree. Compared to this red phase, the yellow phase, the yellow color sinusoidal waveform is going to start its positive half cycle after 120 degree. After 120 degree, it means the yellow phase is going to lag phase A by 120 degree because yellow phase is going to start after 120 degree with respect to omega t equal to 0 degree or with respect to red phase. And the blue phase is going to start its positive half cycle after 120 degree with respect to yellow phase. So blue phase is also called as the lagging waveform with respect to yellow phase by 120 degree. In the other way, this blue phase is going to start its positive half cycle after 240 degree with respect to R phase, with respect to red waveform, with respect to red phase, because red phase has started its positive half cycle at omega t equal to 0 degree. And blue color waveform or the blue phase is going to start its positive half cycle at 240 degree here. So blue color waveform is going to lag red phase 240 degree. Blue color waveform is going to lag A phase by 240 degree, or blue color waveform is going to lag red phase by 240 degree. But in the other fashion, if I'll say that now in the period of 240 degree, in the period of 240 degree, this blue color waveform is having negative half cycle. If we will go in the reverse direction, this negative half cycle is going to complete and it is taking 180 degree period. So from 240 degree, if we will go in the reverse direction, we are getting the negative waveform of blue phase, which is going to complete and it is taking 180 degree period. So 240 minus 180, if I do, okay, this is the instant where omega t equal to 60 degree. This is the instant where omega t equal to 60 degree. So from 0 degree to 60 degree, if I will see, from 0 degree to 60 degree, if I will see, the blue color phase is going to complete its positive half cycle. It is going to complete its positive half cycle. So if it is going to complete its positive half cycle, then at omega t equal to 0, at omega 2 equal to 0, your blue color phase is already started. Blue color phase has already started its positive half cycle with respect to omega t equal to 0. So you can define the relationship of blue phase in two ways. One way, that blue color phase is going to lag red phase by 240 degree, or blue color phase is going to lead the red color phase, while red color phase leading, because at omega t equal to 0, if you will compare, the start of blue color waveform has already done, the blue color waveform has already started its positive half cycle at omega t equal to 0. And how much before, how much angle before? If this is 60 degree, okay, if this duration is 60 degree, and to complete positive half cycle, it requires 180 degree. So 180 degree is equal to x plus 60, because I know this time instant is 60. So this t period is 60 degree period. So before omega t is equal to 0, how much part of positive half cycle it has already completed? That is 120 degree part. It means blue color waveform is leading the red phase by 120 degree. So with this relationship, now if I want to show the phasor diagram of all these three, as red color waveform is going to start its positive half cycle at omega t equal to 0. So it is at reference position. So red color phase is having reference position. With respect to this red phase, the yellow phase is going to start after 120 degree. So yellow phase is going to lag the red phase by 120 degree. So to take this 120 degree clockwise, we have shown the yellow color phasor. So yellow phase is going to lag this red phase by 120 degree. So this 120 degree angle we have taken clockwise to show the lagging angle, that to minus 120 degree lagging angle. Okay. And after yellow phase start, the blue phase is going to start after 120 degree. So with respect to yellow phase start, my blue phase is going to start after 120 degree. So after yellow phase, the blue phase is going to start. It means blue phase is going to lag yellow phase by 120 degree here. Okay, between these two, 120 degree lagging angle is there. And between red phase start and blue phase start, how much is the degree angle is there? 240 degree. So with respect to red phase position, with respect to red phase position, blue color waveform is going to start after 240 degree. So this 120 in clockwise, another 120 in clockwise. So total 240 degree in clockwise angle is going to show you the lagging relationship of this blue phasor with respect to red phasor. If it is 240 degree and clockwise, then how much is in anticlockwise? That is 120 degree in anticlockwise. So this blue color waveform is going to lead this red phase by 120 degree. And this 120 degree, how we have calculated, as I said, that at omega t equal to 0, the blue color waveform has already started its positive half cycle. And here we are showing that the 60 degree period we are getting on positive x-axis, that is after omega t equal to 0. So if the 60 degree period of positive half cycle is there after omega t equal to 0, then how much is the period before omega t equal to 0 it may have? That is 180 minus 60, so 120 degree before. So blue color waveform has started its positive half cycle 120 degree before omega t equal to 0. So here we are telling, we are showing the relationship of blue phase in both the ways, that blue phase is going to lead the red phase by 120 degree. Blue color phase is going to lead the red phase by 120 degree, or blue color phase is going to lag the red phase by 240 degree. So I hope you have understood the relationship of three phases: red color phase, yellow color phase and blue color phase. So red phase is going to start its positive half cycle at omega t equal to 0 degree. Yellow color phase is going to start its positive half cycle after 120 degree with respect to R. Then the blue color phase is going to start its positive half cycle after 120 degree with respect to Y phase start, or the blue color phase is going to start its positive half cycle after 240 degree with respect to red phase start, or the blue color phase is going, or it has already started its positive half cycle 120 degree before omega t equal to 0. So blue color phase is going to lead the red phase by 120 degree. Okay. Now in this three phase AC supply, when we are dealing, okay, then there are two sides of circuits. One is the input side, another one is the output side. The input side is called as a three phase AC supply, as we are giving three phases, okay, we are connecting three wires, red color, yellow color and blue color. So it is going to give me three phase AC supply, and this supply is going to connect to the three phase AC load. So we have just now, we have seen that three phase motor has connected to three phase AC supply. So motor is acting as what? Motor is acting as a load, okay, and then three phase live wires which was there at the upper side, it is called as what? It is called as three phase AC supply. So three phase AC supply side is going to supply the voltage and current to the load side. So this three phase AC supply is connected to three phase AC load through this four arrows I have shown. So the red color arrow is going from supply to load, which is representing R phase. Yellow color line is representing Y phase, which is supplying from phase, from supply to load. Blue color line represents blue phase, which is again having the direction from supply side to load side. And the black color line represents the neutral wire, which is also going from supply side to load side. Okay. So always the wires will go from supply side to load side to supply the required voltage and required current to the load. So when I am connecting mixer in my home through the 3-pin plug, okay, to my wall socket, okay, that wall socket is having 3-pin socket. So in that 3-pin socket, I am inserting the 3-pin plug of my mixer. Then I will say that the wall socket of 3-pin plug, okay, is called as the supply side, and the mixer which I have connected to that, it is called as load side. So through the mixie, I want to grind something. So my work to be done, that is a grinding operation, which I am doing with the help of mixer. So mixer is going to act as a load. So load we are connecting to AC supply system to do the desirable work. Okay. So now these loads which are connected to this three phase AC supply system is having two types of connection. We are having two types of plugs, 3-pin plug and 2-pin plug. So whenever I said that, whenever we are going to deal with washing machine, mixer, refrigerator, we are having three pin plug. So three pin plug is called as three wire. That is phase, neutral and earthing. Okay, so some equipments requires three wire circuits in single phase AC supply. Some equipments require two wire circuits in single phase supply, like mobile charger. Okay, so mobile charger is having only two pins. So two pins is having two wire AC supply. And three pin plug is giving me three wire AC supply. Both are required single phase only. Both are taking single phase only, because in three pin plug also phase is only one. So three terminals are one phase, one neutral and one earthing. And in two pin plug, one phase and one neutral. So whenever I have three pin plug or two pin plug, the number of phases in that is only one. So the supply which is going to act in both cases, it is called as a single phase AC supply. Because if whenever we have two pin plug or three pin plug, number of phases are only one. As number of phases is only one, okay, so one terminal is phase terminal, second terminal is the neutral terminal, and third terminal is the earthing terminal, which is optional. Okay, similarly, the three phase AC load also required different wire connection. So in three phase AC supply, as we are connecting this supply to load, we are going to measure the voltage and current. Okay, what I said, we are connecting load to the supply. When we are connecting load to the supply, we are going to measure certain parameters at supply side and load side. So the parameters which we are measuring at supply side, there are two parameters. One is called voltage, another one is called current. And at load side also, we are going to measure voltage and current. The voltage and current which we are going to measure at supply side, it's called as a line current and line voltage. The current and the voltage which we are going to measure at supply side, it's called as line current and line voltage. And the voltage and the current which we are going to measure at load side, it's called as a phase current and phase voltage. Now the line current, why it is called line current? Because at supply side, we are representing that three phase AC supply by three different color lines. We are representing three phase AC supply by using three different color lines. So every line is acting as every live wire. Okay, so the current passing through that live wire is called as a line current, and the voltage across that particular live wire is called as a line voltage. So voltage across any supply terminal is called as a line voltage, and current flow through any supply terminal is called as a line current. And similarly, when I want to measure current across any load, it is called as a phase current. And when I want to measure the voltage across any load, I will say it is phase voltage. So this you should keep in mind clearly. When I will use the term line, when I am dealing with supply side, when I am measuring any current or any voltage at supply side, I will call that voltage and that current as a line current and line voltage. And when I want to measure any voltage and current at load side, I will call that particular current as a phase current, and I will call that particular voltage as a phase voltage. Okay. Now let's see the loads. Okay, the types of three phase AC loads are of two types: star connected load, delta connected. As I said that, in single phase AC supply, we have discussed about two wire circuit and three wire circuit. So two wire circuit and three wire circuit is having differentiation that it is two pin plug required and three pin plug required. But similarly, in three phase load, certain load require four wire supply and certain load require three wire supply. Okay, so star connected load deals with four wire circuits. Okay, and delta connected load deals with three wire circuits. Now how, let's see. First connection is the star connection. Okay, now in star connection, we are having four terminals: A, B, C, and fourth is neutral. As it is having four terminal A, B, C, N, so it requires four wire supply. So star connection deals with three phase four wire supply. Three phase four wire. Three phase means red phase, yellow phase, blue phase, and fourth is the neutral. So neutral is not the phase. Neutral is called as a return path, because in single phase AC supply also we are calling one terminal is a phase terminal, another terminal is the neutral terminal. Okay, so when I have a one phase and one neutral, that supply is called as a single phase AC supply because phase is only one. Similarly, in star connection, we have four terminals. Out of these four terminal, we have three phases and one terminal is neutral. Fourth terminal is neutral. As it is having three phases and fourth terminal is in neutral, that supply is called as a three phase supply. Now, how it is having fourth terminal? See, the phase A, okay, which is having red color phase, okay, then this is yellow color phase and this is blue color phase, okay. Now, these phases are representing in the form of coils. Now, why coils? Because in three phase AC supply, the loads which we are connecting, it is either in motor or in transformer form. And motor, we are taking windings. Okay, when we are connecting motor, every motor is having winding. And windings are nothing but in the form of coils. So, we are representing these three branches in the terms of coils. So, these are not inductor or these are not resistor. These are windings. These are coils. Okay, so red phase coil, yellow phase coil and blue phase coil. As I said, these are the industry names are A, B, C. So, A winding is denoted by red color, B by yellow color and C by blue color. Okay. Now every winding or every coil is having its start terminal and end terminal. So one denotes start and two denotes end. So red phase coil is having start 1, end 2. Yellow phase coil is having start 1, end 2. And blue phase is having start 1 and end 2. Now in this star connection, the end terminals of all phases, the end terminals of all phase coils are connected together and form one junction point or form one common point. And this common point is called as a neutral. And because of this common junction point, we have fourth terminal called neutral terminal. And because of this neutral terminal, this connection requires three phase four wire supply. So you can represent this star in this pattern or this pattern also. So we can represent the star connection in two forms. Either three vertical lines whose ends are joined together and giving the common terminal called neutral, and remaining three terminals at the upper side called their starting terminals called the phase terminals A, B, C or R, Y, B. You can denote in any fashion. Okay, you can say even R, Y, B also. So R, Y, B and neutral is the three phase four wire supply in star connection. Similarly, the same pattern we have represented in another fashion. Again, A coil, B coil and C coil I have taken just in a X or say in a star pattern. And the end terminals of A coil, end terminals of B coil and end terminals of C coils I join together. And this combined point, which is called as a junction point, is called as a neutral. And then remaining points, that is start of A coil, okay, is giving you A phase. Start of C is giving you, start of C is supposed to C and start of B supposed to B. So A, B, C and neutral, this is called as a star connection. So star connection deals with three phase, four wire supply. Whereas the second connection is called as a delta connection. Now what means delta connection? As I have taken three coils, A coil, B coil and C coil, and every coil is having start terminal and end terminal. So one indicates start and two indicates end. Okay, so how delta is going to connect? The start of first is going to connect to end of second, and start of second, that is B, is going to connect to the end of third, that is C. Okay. So, one of B is going to connect two of C. So, one of B means start of B is going to connect to the end of C. And start of C is going to connect to the end of first. So, start terminal of first coil is going to connect to the end of second. Similarly, again, start of second coil is going to connect to the end of third. And start of third is going to connect to the end of first. So, this delta connection is going to represent in the another form also, as I am taking three coils in a triangular pattern. So this is A coil, red in color, B coil, yellow in color, C coil, blue in color. Okay. So say this is start of A. So start of A is going to end of B. Then start of B is going to connect end of C. And start of C is going to connect to end of A. So it is giving you a complete closed loop path. And this closed loop path is going to give you three terminals. First junction point, second junction point and third junction point. So each junction point, first junction point is called as A terminal, second junction point is called as a B terminal and third junction point is called as a C terminal. So this particular connection is having only three terminals. As it is having three terminals, it requires only three wires. So delta connection deals with three wire supply, which require three phase. And star connection deals with four wire supply, which again deals with three phase. So both the types are deals with the both circuits, star connected circuit also and delta connected circuit also require three phases, ABC or say RYB. But star connection requires one more terminal, say called neutral. So it is having three phase four wire supply and delta connection doesn't have neutral. So it deals with only three phase three wire supply. Okay. Now why this second connection is called as a delta? Because if I am taking this red coil, suppose in vertical way, suppose I am going to connect this red color coil in vertical way, or if I am taking that coil in vertical way, okay, then these another two sides of the triangle are forming D shape, D. Okay, so that's why D for delta, so this connection is called as a delta. Is everyone understood clearly what means 3 phase 4 wire and what means 3 phase 3 wire? 3 phase 4 wire means star connection, 3 phase 3 wire means delta connection. The fourth terminal is called as a neutral terminal. The neutral terminal is present only in star connection. Neutral terminal doesn't present in delta connection. Star terminals are RYB neutral, or you can say ABC neutral, and delta terminals are RYB or ABC. So this is called as a polyphase AC supply.